We love having some blueberries with our breakfast, and they come in these cardboard boxes, which are so handy for storing stuff in. So I've kept a whole lot of those over the years, and now I want to make a rack to put them on. I need a lot of boards for this project, and I'm cutting those out of 2x4 and 2x6 material. First cutting it to width, and then resawing it, and I'm using a very thin 7¼-inch handheld circular saw blade. And the advantage of that is it cuts very thin and I can cut very fast because my saw is actually not that powerful. Got my pieces for the front and back frames cut out. Now I need some pieces that the boxes rest on and can be slid in and out on. And just like the other pieces, these start out as 2x4s, first cutting them to length, then cutting them into slices, and then cutting those slices into halves to make the narrow pieces that the boxes rest on. Lots more small pieces cut, and this is how the frames are going to go together on the inside to hold the boxes like this. I made two sticks with lots of notches cut in them, and that'll help me line up where the supports for the boxes will go. So because this is more of a thing for just storing boxes in the basement, I decided to make this one a bit quick and rough. So I didn't even plane my boards after resawing them, partially to preserve thickness, and I'm using construction adhesive because that's much better at filling gaps and just nailing it together with a brad nailer. Now, after having done the one side, I can flip it over and I'm attaching my little guide things here for placing those rails on there again. And I'm also switching to longer nails in the brad nailer because these brad nails now, I want to shoot them all the way through and hit the guide rail on the other side as well. I'm having a hard time getting that construction adhesive to stick even on the one side. I figure it'll do better once it's pressed together, but the tube of that construction adhesive is not the newest and that probably doesn't help. And I should have put these pieces that go in between the rails in initially because, as it is, I have to bang the vertical parts apart a little bit because somehow I've got the pieces too close together. Those pieces are important because they keep the cardboard boxes from going in slightly diagonal as I push them in, and then they'd hit the vertical parts, and with these pieces they kind of guide them in there like a drawer. Then more construction adhesive and using a small piece of wood to actually try to spread that glue around because it's gotten a bit thick. That glue is just old. Then putting the rails on the other side was pretty fast, although that nail gun misfires quite a lot. I found it in a dumpster many years ago, and I think I'm pretty sure why that nail gun ended up in a dumpster in the first place. Assembling that first frame wasn't as elegant as I'd hoped it would be, so then I assembled the next one off of camera, and then I figured I had it just right for filming the next one and getting everything right on camera. But that was not to be. So I realized it was just a little bit off of square, and I just for the life of me couldn't get the thing back in square. And eventually I realized the problem was I had swapped back to the shorter nails, but the wrong shorter nails, and these nails were long enough to nail the thing straight to my workbench. And when I tried to adjust it into square, it just wouldn't budge, and I hadn't yet realized that it nailed the thing onto my workbench while it was crooked. So right here is where I realized the thing was nailed to my workbench.
Oh shit.
So I pried it off and decided to flip the whole thing over and work on the other side first.
Shit.
And here that nail gun didn't just misfire, it jammed real good that I had to open it up and get the jammed nail out of there. And only now did I realize I forgot to put the pieces that go between the rails in there, but fortunately I was able to slide them in and nail them on. And with all my trying to do a quick and dirty shop project, it just wasn't very precise, and looking at it, the joints didn't close very much, so I actually had to clamp some of them after the fact, and I tried to do it quick, but the quickness really didn't save time over doing it properly. Now with these middle dividers glued up, it's time to cut the joiner for the outside frame. I'm starting by cutting the box joints for the very outside corners. I also need some mortises in the sides of the pieces that'll go on the bottom. If I didn't cut those mortises now, the only way to attach the right pieces on there later would be pocket holes, and I really want to avoid that. Then some mortises in the top and bottom of the front pieces. Those aren't strictly necessary, but they'll really help to stiffen the whole frame, I think. And I also need some corresponding mortises in the dividers on the front side, top and bottom. That'll allow me to join that to the bottom and top parts of the frame using floating tenons. And now joining the outside parts of the overall box, I think I cut those joints a little bit too tight. I had to move this one down to the floor so I could bang it a little bit harder. Now I just need to cut some mortises in the ends of the pieces that'll connect the two frames on the bottom. And I also have to make a whole bunch of floating tenons for that. And I like to chamfer the edges of those things because it makes it easier to push them in, and I think it also helps to prevent them from scraping all the glue out of the way when they go in. Now, those connection pieces aren't so much there to hold the two frames together. Their main function is to provide a support for the boxes so they don't fall out the bottom of the frame. There's still sawdust in that mortise, and now I got glue in it too. And now it's another one of those times where I have to get a whole lot of mortise and tenon joints to line up all at once and get them all together. And with the frames now attached together, I can now start attaching the sticks to the insides. Those will be the ones that'll hold up the blueberry boxes. And making sure everything is square before I put the second nail on each end of those little rails, because that will end up locking the angle. And now flipping it over so I can do the same thing on the other side. And this one required a little bit of clamping to get it into square. And I like to chamfer these exposed edges, that way they don't hurt if I touch them, and they also won't dig into the cardboard so much. And I also like to taper them on the front, that'll make it easier to put the cardboard boxes in without them getting caught on things. And also, especially beveling those front edges, again, it just makes it easier to get the box in there without it getting caught.
Now these dividers go in last, because if I put those in any earlier, it would have been really difficult to nail those things in place, just no room for the nail gun. Plus, I wanted to be able to assemble those front frames with a box joint on their own. And also, I have to put these things in there, and then nail these things in there. So I thought a lot about the order of operations, and putting these things in last is the easiest. And because they use floating tenons, I can just stick the tenons in from the top and bottom afterwards like that.
I just flipped this thing upside down and glued the tenons in on the bottom side, and you may wonder why these tenons. I could have just put some screws or nails in here, but these are actually there to keep this whole thing from racking, because right now it's just the box joints in the corners, but by having a rigid joint with these floating tenons in here, that keeps the whole rack from racking side to side. And why none on the back? Well, simple, there's going to be a plywood panel on the back, and that'll keep that from racking, but the front is all open.
But wouldn't that rigid back panel also prevent the front from racking? Not quite.
Take this blueberry box, for example. If it's flat on my workbench, it can't rack. But if I pick it up, I can twist it. And if we prevent that front from racking, this thing will be proof against twisting. Just try it yourself. An open shoebox will twist, but a closed one will not. I want the tenons to have full thickness over the width of this here, but that means they stick into the opening here. So now I have to cut that off a little bit after the fact. All right, now let's finally try that thing with blueberry boxes in it.
When I put the blueberry boxes in on this side, some of them would hit on here like this because they don't have a guide on the side here like they do here. And I was going to solve that by just putting a plywood side on here. But I think this looks way better open. So I'm just going to glue some bits of wood on here like so to keep those boxes on track. So it still needs a top and the back, but I think for a YouTube thumbnail, it'll look cooler without.
I almost forgot to nail those dividers on the back side. And I always keep some extra shitty used plywood around, just for uses like this. And an added bonus with those scraps, almost no cutoffs. It's just always very satisfying how individual pieces of wood glued together form a solid cabinet like that.
So now all these rarely used random bits and bobs have a place to go instead of just lying around everywhere.